Hi guys, welcome back to my channel, and in this video I'm going to use a 500 farads 2.7 volts super capacitor to excite the field winding of a car alternator for running it as a DC motor, high RPM and high torque. Now this is a digital meter for measuring the voltage and the current consumed by the controller that is going to run the alternator as a BLDC motor. Now I got this from a Banggood, and a link to buy this product will also be provided in the description. So guys, this video is sponsored by LCSC, which is a Chinese company. LCSC has grown into one of the largest electronics component distributor in China with over 900,000 customers, and they have a product range of 200,000 from semiconductors to resistors, capacitors, inductors, transistors, sensors, etc. In total they have around 3,000 daily orders, so don't forget to check them out. Link is in the description. Guys, this multimeter can measure voltage up to 100 volts and current up to 10 amperes. Guys, it also requires an external power supply to operate with a voltage range of 4 volts to 30 volts. So guys, this is a 2.7 volts 500 farad green cap supercapacitor that I've already used in my previous video. Also guys, link to buy this product has been provided in the description. And this one you might have seen in many of my videos in which I converted a car alternator into a DC motor, and this is the alternator that I will be using to run with the supercapacitor by exciting its field, although main power will be given by the battery. And at the same time I'm also going to connect this multimeter to measure the current consumed by the alternator at no load, and also the losses of the controller and the meter itself. So guys, as you can see, the thin yellow wire from the meter will be connected to the positive of the load. The thick red wire from the meter will be connected to the negative of the load. And again, the thin red wire from the meter will be connected to the positive of the load. Also guys, this type of connection of the multimeter to the load is applicable only when you are powering up the multimeter with the same load with which your load is being operated. Like I am going to operate the controller with this UPS battery, and with the same battery I am also going to operate this multimeter. So in that case this type of connection is applied. Otherwise, if you want to power up this multimeter not with the same power source, then you will have to connect the thin black wire that has been left out and the red wire, the thin red wire, to an external power supply ranging from 4 volts to 30 volts. Now guys, you might see that the display is fluctuating. That is because the display is switching at a very high speed, and I have recorded this video in 1080p 60fps, and that high speed switching of the display screen of this multimeter can be seen at 60 frames per second, but it shows constant display when seen with the naked eye. Guys, here as you can see I'm connecting the BLDC controller no Hall sensor type to the alternator, which you have already seen me connect in a few of my previous videos. So it's time to power up the alternator. So guys, as you can see that the armature of the alternator has been connected to the controller, and the meter is measuring the power being consumed at no load. So it is around 13 volts and 0.02 amps. Okay. So it is very less power for activating the controller and the power being consumed by the meter itself. Now guys, note that I have not connected any external power source to the field winding of the alternator. So first I am going to test this situation. Let's try and turn the knob of the controller. You can see that the alternator rotor is shaking, and the controller and the multimeter is indicating that it is drawing huge amount of current and the alternator is not starting up. You can see the current is as high as 8 amperes. Okay, now what I'm going to do is connect a 3.7 volts lithium-ion battery to the field and then try it. So the alternator has started running at a high speed and the meter is indicating 12.1 volts at 2.6 amperes. And as I rotate the knob, the parameters change on the meter. Now to indicate better rotation, I've connected a clip. As it can be seen, the alternator has started running and it is drawing around 3 amperes or 4 amperes at 12 volts from the UPS battery. The speed is very high, yeah, and the operation is smooth as before. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to use this circuit to charge the supercapacitor. So guys, I would say that exceptionally high speed is seen when the field winding of the alternator is excited with the help of a supercapacitor, and that is because the voltage of a supercapacitor is very low and the current is very high. So for that reason, I think the speed is very high.